Today what we are going to do is biasing of BJT circuits. So biasing of the BJT circuits is done mainly from the aim that we achieve a very stable cue point. Today in the lab we are going to have basically analyze three types of biasing circuits and then compare the results and analyze them and then see how the variation in cue point is. So let us see what those three biasing techniques are. So what we are going to see mainly today is the design of biasing circuits. Mainly biasing is done. So the word biasing means we need to bias this at a good voltage and current level in the circuit. So a good voltage and current level in a BJT is given by the Q point, or Q point is also known as the quiescent point. So the quiescent point is normally shown in the output characteristics. And it is a function of VCE and IC, and commonly known as VCEQ and ICEQ. So today we are going to analyze three types of biasings, that is fixed biasing, modified fixed biasing and the voltage divider biasing. The voltage divider biasing is commonly used for, or it is used in the CE configuration or CE amplifiers. Now let us say, or let us take an example of designing all three of them for the same cue point, that is cue point of 5 millivolts and 2 milliamperes. Now when we say a cue point of 5 volts and 2 milliamperes, we mean to say that we want this cue point to be there in the active region of operation of the transistor. So what is this active region of operation of the transistor is what we can see on the output characteristics, that is IC and VCEQ. So normally this is going to be the nature of the DC load line, and generally the BJT has got a output characteristics which is somewhat like this, and this is your VCC by the slope of this line, which varies depending upon biasing used, and so that is that value that comes in this place. This value is resistive in nature, and this value, it comes out to be VDD. We see that through equations for different biasing techniques. So normally it is what during amplification, what is that the cue point present in the active region of operation. So we want the cue point to be somewhere in this place. So an ideal position would be somewhere in the center of this DC load line, and that is what we want to achieve. So a stable VCEQ and ICEQ, this cue point. So we want to achieve a stable cue point. So stable cue point means we want this cue point to be more or less in this position itself, or at the center of the DC load line, for variations in VCEQ or ICEQ. Mainly the variations will be because of ICEQ. So for that purpose, we want to see how much would be the variation of this Q point on this DC load line. Now what we essentially are going to do is, we are going to do all these biasing techniques with transistor 2N222A. So when I select 2N222A, it is going to have some IC max rating. It is going to have an HFE which is around 220 and a stability factor that is mainly with respect to ICBO, that is less than 10. So now let us see a fixed biasing circuit. Fixed bias. So that is going to be, so the fixed bias circuit looks this way. The bias is fixed, that is through RB, and this is your VCC, and it's going to be ground. So this is going to be your RC, VCE, and VBE, and this is your RB, and the base current is going to flow through RB, and the collector current flows through IC, and what flows here is IE, which is actually the sum of IC and IB, but IB is very small, so you can assume IE to be equal to IC. Now if we apply KVL on the input side, we have some equations, that is VCC, so VCC minus IBRB minus VBE, that is VBE equal to 0. So this is KVL on input side. So we have this equation, that is from this we can write IB is equal to VCC minus VBE upon RB, but the main intention here is not to find IB but to find RB, that is the circuit components based on the Q point that is given to us, that is 5 volts comma 2 milliamperes and for a VCC of 10 volts. So in this equation we can write or modify as RB is equal to VCC minus VBE by IB. So in this case we can write VCC to be equal to 10 minus 0.7 by IB, which is also 10 minus 0.7 by IC by HFE. So we can write RB is nothing but HFE for the 2N222A is equal to, so HFE for this transistor is 220, so that is going to be 220 into 10 minus 0.7 upon IC. So the IC value that we have chosen is nothing but this, that is ICQ, that is 2 into 10 raised to minus 3. So when we solve this, what we get is around RB to be almost equal to, now let us look at the next design, that is nothing but the modified fixed bias. So what we modify in this is that we put an emitter resistance there. So the rest of the circuit is the same, that is your RB, that is VCC, RC, RB, but what an additional resistance of RE is added into this. So as we know that addition of RE leads to a better stability of the biasing circuit. IC flows through RC, IB flows through RB, plus minus VBE, and so these are the terminal voltages of the transistor. And of course, IE is going to be IC plus IB, but in most of the cases, IE is almost equal to IC. Now, we are again designing this same circuit, that is, we are designing the modified fixed bias circuit for the same Q point. So, my Q point does not change. So, my Q point does not change. It means that if the Q point does not change, what essentially has to change is the circuit values. So we might have got some value of RC in the fixed bias circuit, but now what we can see, since the Q point remains same and there is an addition of RE, what is essentially going to change is the values of RB, RC and RE. So let us see that again. So again, what we can have is, we can analyze the input side separately and we can then analyze the output side. So let us say calculation of RE. Now, in most of the designs, we assume that, or to achieve a stable Q point or for a good feedback, we assume that the voltage across RE is 10% of VCC. Now in this case, my VCC is fixed to 10 volts. HFE is again the same because we are using 2N222A, and then what we are getting is IC max is again the same, that is 100 milliamperes. So what we will take here is that 10% of VCC is going to be 1 volt. So VRE is 1 volt, and what we essentially have is VRE is also equal to IC, or initially IE by RE, or almost equal to IC by RE. So from this we can write RE is equal to V. RE is equal to, sorry, small error here. So that is IE times RE, and that is also equal to IC times of RE. So RE is VRE by IC. So that is 1 volt by IC. So IC is nothing but ICQ, that is 1 volt by 2 milliamperes, and that is going to be 0.5 kilo ohms, or let us say 500 ohms. So RE comes out to be around 500 ohms in this case. So a standard value could be around 470, or you can take as a 500 ohms itself. So RE can be 470 ohms standard. And to calculate PRE, we have IC square RE. So do not use this value because we need to use the standard value, that is IC square is nothing but again 2 milliampere square into 470 ohms. So again, this value is going to be less than quarter watt. So we can write select RE is equal to 470 ohms quarter watt. That is the calculation of RE. Now once we are done with the calculation of RE, we can go for calculation of RB. So in the calculation of RB, we need to apply KVL on input side, that is VCC minus IBRB minus VBE minus IC times RE to be equal to 0. Now IB is IC by beta, so we can write VCC minus IC by beta in this case is HFE, that is HFE RB minus VBE minus IC into RE equal to 0. So what all things are known? So VCC, IC, HFE, VBE, again IC and RE are known now. So what is unknown is just RB. So we can write RB is equal to VCC minus VBE minus ICQ RE upon, so we have or by HFE is equal to VCC minus VB minus ICQ into RE equal to, so that is going to be that is IC in this place. So we can write here RB, when we substitute all the values of VCC, IC, HFE, VB, IC, VB is 0.7, so RB comes up to around 726.15 kilo ohms. Again we need to calculate PRB, that is going to be IB square by RB, that is, so this value is again in microamperes square. So how IB can be calculated? IB is nothing but IC by HFE. So IC is given to us, that is 2 milliamperes, and HFE is 220. So we can see that the value is going to be milliamperes divided by 220, that is why it's in microamperes, and because of that I write your microampere square into RB, but RB is in some kilo ohms, so something in kilo ohm, so less than again a quarter watt. So we can write select RB equal to ...726 is the value. So what you can do is you can select a slightly lower value, that is 680 kilo ohms, that is standard, along with a quarter watt specification. Now how do we calculate RC? That is, let us look at the calculation of RC. So again we apply KVL on the KVL on output side. So we have VCC minus ICRC minus VCE minus IERE equal to 0. IERE is nothing but VRE, and which is computed to around 1 volts. So what we again have here is VCC is known, IC known, VC known, and the only unknown is RC. So RC is computed out to be around so we can write VCC minus VCE minus VRE upon IC is the value of RC. So that computes to be, so that is, again if you want you can solve that thing out. So 10 minus 5 minus 1 volt upon IC values 2 milliamperes. So RC computes to be around 2 kilo ohms, and PRC is going to be ICQ square into RC. So ICQ, again it is in milliamperes square into something in kilo ohms, again less than a quarter watt, and hence we can write select RC is equal to 2 kilo ohms quarter watt. So now we have your RC, select RC to be equal to around 2 kilo ohms and quarter watt. So now what we have is we have RC we have RB, that is the standard value, then we have RE, and all these biasings are designed for 2N222A. That means now all the specs are in place and we can again implement this particular circuit on the breadboard. So now we are going to see the third kind of biasing, that is voltage divider. So we have seen fixed bias, modified bias. Now we are going to see the voltage divider biasing. So slightly different to design. So voltage divider biasing. So naturally we need to have a voltage divider first. So RC, RE. So again the current flowing here is IC and here is it is IE, and the current flowing into the base is nothing but IB. So there is a slight modification we need to do first when we look at voltage divider biasing. So we modify the input side, so we can modify the input side and the circuit becomes this way. So we can replace the circuit between V point between the base and the ground by an equivalent circuit with the help of a Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So Thevenin's equivalent is essentially an RT in series with a VT value. Now what this VT value is, so VT is the voltage at VB. So that is nothing but using potential divider bias. So VT value is, VT is going to be some part of VCC through the biasing circuit. So VT, we can observe that it is R2 upon R1 plus R2 into VCC, RC, RE plus minus VC plus minus VBE. And RT value is calculated by short circuiting all the power sources in the circuit. So when we short circuit VCC, R1 comes in parallel to R2 and this point is common, so we get RT is R1 parallel to R2. Now this remains the same, that is IB, IC and I. Okay. Now when we look at this circuit, again we say VRE is going to be 10% of VCC. So this assumption is the same as that in the modified fixed bias, that is 10 upon 100 into 10, that is 1 volt. So VRE is 1 volt and VRE is also equal to IERE, and we assume that IE is almost equal to IC, so ICRE. So from this we can write RE is equal to VRE by IC. Now IC we are assuming that for the, again the Q point is going to be 5 volts comma 2 milliamperes. So this is your ICEQ, then we have VCEQ. So ICEQ is going to be 1 volt by 2 milliamperes. So my RE comes out to be around 0.5 kilo ohms or 500 ohms. Now IC is going to be essentially smaller than IE. That is why this value may be slightly lesser than that of 500 ohms. So what we can do is RE is going to be equal to, let us select 470 ohms standard, and PRE is going to be equal to IE square RE. That is, IE is again almost equal to IC. So let us say something in milliampere square into something in ohms, so that is going to be less than quarter watt. So we can write select RE equal to 470 ohms standard and quarter watt. Now again we can have a look at the input circuit, that is KVL on input side is going to be VT minus IB into RT minus VBE minus IERE equal to 0. So VT is nothing but R2 R1 plus R2 upon VCC, and but we have not yet calculated values of R2 upon R1 plus R2, so we don't have values of R1 and R2, so we have to hold on this particular value. But before we go to that, we can write, so what we have here is IE, VBE and IB, and RT is nothing but R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. So now we need to handle the values of RT first, which has got R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2, and VT is also having R2 R1 plus R2 into VCC. So we will be able to apply KVL only if we have the values of R1 and R2 first. So let us see how to calculate that. So we know that SICO for the transistor is less than or equal to 10. So let us say that SICO, and that is equal to 1 plus RB by RE. So 10 equal to 1 plus RB by RE. So we can write RB, or RB in this case is nothing but RT. That is RB equal to RT equal to 9 by RE. So RE value we already know. So we can write R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2 is equal to 9 by RE. So 9RE is already there, that is 470 ohms. So this value comes out to be SICO value we can see that R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2 computes to 9 into 470, that is 4.230 kilo ohms. Now let us look at further analysis. That is R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2 is equal to 4.230 kilo ohms. At the same time, VT minus IB RB minus VBE minus IERE equal to 0. So we have VT, RB is nothing but RT, that is Thevenin's equivalent, and this is VRE. So VT is equal to IB times RT minus VB plus VBE plus IE RE equal to 0. So that is essentially going to be IC by HFE into RT, that is 4.230 kilo ohms plus 0.7 plus 1 volt equal to 0. So this computes out to be 1.73 volts, that is VT. But we also know that VT is equal to R2 upon R1 plus R2 into VCC. So R2, so if we consider this as equation 1 and equation 2, from this equation we can substitute the value of R2 upon R1 plus R2 into as 4.230 kilo ohms, that is 4.230 kilo ohms divide into divided by R1 is equal to VT, which is 1.73. So from this we can calculate R1 to be equal to, R1 comes out to be around 24.08 kilo ohms. So we can select 25 kilo ohms as standard, and by using this R1 value we can substitute this R1 in the same equation, that is this equation. So we have R1 upon R1 plus R2 into R2 equal to 4.230 kilo ohms. But when we use this equation, now R1 is known, so the only unknown is R2, and R2 computes to 5.712 kilo ohms. And so now we have R1, we have R2, and then we have our RE. Now the only calculation remaining is RC. So RC computes out, so we have to apply what, KVL on the output side. So our RE value is the same, that is around 470 ohms. So when we apply KVL on the output side, that is in the case of calculation of RC, so our VRE is the same, that is 1 volt, VC is 5, VCC is 10, and then RC computes out to be the same value even in case of voltage divider biasing. So even in case of voltage divider biasing, if we look at the two circuits, that is VCC minus ICRC minus VC minus IRE, so the calculation of RC same as modified fixed bias. So now we have here even RC is equal to 2 kilo ohms, we have RE equal to 470 kilo ohms, and we have R1 and R2 values which are around, let us say, 4.230 kilo ohms and 5.712 kilo ohms. So all the circuit values are known now, and we can implement this circuit using transistor 2N222A. So that computes. So we have solved all the three voltage divider biasings and all the biasing techniques, and then we can implement this, all the three techniques, on the breadboard.